Hi, so I want to give you a quick introduction to limits, a more intuitive and descriptive of what limits are doing, and then we'll talk about kind of the methods for evaluating limits in the next few videos. But limits are the basis for all of calculus and an especially important part of finding the derivative of a function. So I want you guys to at least have an understanding of what's going on. So I went ahead and graphed a quadratic function, x squared minus 4x plus 1. And you guys can graph this using a t-table or finding the vertex, however you want. But it looks like this, and I want to take a look specifically at this point 4, 1, okay, which is marked in red there, and I've labeled it. Now, we have learned in this class, and I assume you guys knew before, how to evaluate functions. So, how to evaluate a function at a point. For example, this is how I found the output value f of 4, and I would plug this in 4 squared minus 4 times 4 plus 1 should equal 1. And I get an input and an output, and I get this point 4, 1 on my graph. Okay? Okay, so we know how to do that. In limits, I am no longer interested in exactly what's happening at the point. In fact, I'm not going to use this evaluation technique at all. With limits, I am interested in what's happening in a neighborhood of the point. Okay? So on the x-axis, to look at what's happening around 4, maybe I would look in some neighborhood between 3 and 5, right in here on the x-axis. Okay? And I'm trying to see, looking at those input values, and I will try and figure out what's happening to the output values also in that neighborhood. So it gives me a sense of what's happening here on the graph between kind of 3, I'm going to highlight this part of the graph, between 3 and 5. It gives me an idea of what the output values are doing in that area as the values move closer and closer to my number 4. Okay? So let me look at I blew up this picture and kind of I want to look at that a little bit more. So really in a limit, what I'm going to do is step points closer and closer to 4 on the x-axis. So I will look here like at an input value of 3.1. And I'll look at what the output value is, which is somewhere here. I'll look at the input value of like 3.2. I'm going to step that even closer to the value 4 and see what the output value is doing. Step a little bit closer, 3.3. See what the output value is doing, right? As I get closer and closer to 4, you see these output values moving up and closer to the output of 4. In this case, because this is a specific type of function, but at least these, I kind of see a pattern developing in where the output values are going. And if there's a pattern developing, if the output values are all converging on a single number, then we'll say that a limit exists. And that's the limit from the left, if I look at points from the left. Now, I can also look at points from the right here. So if I take a look at, say, 4.9, step a little bit closer, 4.8, 4.7, 4.6, I'm going to step closer and closer. And as I do that, I am looking here at what these output values are doing. When I do that, the output values are moving down in this direction and they're kind of headed towards some sort of destination. Okay? That moving towards a destination, the destination will be the limit of this function as it moves towards this point. So I'm no longer interested in what's happening exactly at the point, but I am going to have these x values kind of move closer and closer and closer to this place that I'm interested in. And then what the output values are doing is kind of the idea of the limit. So in this case, for example, when x gets close to 4, x equal to 4, the output, this function, x squared minus 4x plus 1, gets close to 1. And we'll see that again in the next video when we talk about left-sided limits and right-sided limits. This is a continuous function, so they're the same from both sides, but we'll look at examples where they're not the same, and then we'll talk about two-sided limits as well. So please just keep this idea of kind of converging in on the x values from the left side and then from the right side, and taking a look and seeing what this function is doing and seeing what the output values are doing. Okay, let me know if you have any questions.